I think the best way to do it would be relatable, not relatable.
These are good.
Before we jump into it, there's been an update on one of my relatable, not relatables. Someone's listening up there. Songs that are 100% perfect. And I think maybe we'll listen to one or pause it and we can react.
Okay.
But we're just going to vibe. The listeners are going to vibe. They're going to be in the car. But this song is perfect.
Hello, 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 people.
Yo, yo, yo.
How are we all going? We hope we're going good. We're going good. This is episode 55 or 56.
Good guess.
So, yeah, Oddy and I have been, because we're going away, we've been pre-recording.
Man.
So, this is the third one today.
I've been talking to Jake too much.
So, yeah, we've got, we're on time crunch now.
Yeah.
We've left it. Well, we didn't leave it too late. We've been busy. We've got lives still, you know. We've got work to do. We had families to hang out with, but we still wanted to bring out the episodes for you guys.
So, didn't want to miss one.
We didn't want to miss one. We were talking about maybe missing a Friday, but then...
like, Jake, we can't do it.
We were like, yeah, Audie was like, Jake, we can't do this. We can't do this to the listeners.
I feel guilty.
So we thought we'd feel a lot better if we bring you guys something. We're still putting... We're not going to lack on the content. It may lack on the time. It may be a quick one. Quality over quantity.
That's
we don't want to just jibber jabber.
That's what we say in bed, mate. Quality over quantity. That's how it works.
Yeah, quality over quantity.
It doesn't matter how long you last. It's how good it is.
About how good it is.
And this potty is going to be good.
It could quite possibly be the best half an hour of your life. Or if you're with Audie and I in bed, could quite possibly be the best 2 minutes of your life.
Best
30 seconds of your life.
This potty might be 30 seconds. Might be the best 30 seconds you've ever listened to.
Yes, yes. We'll give him that. So, look. You know, hit us with the 5 stars. We know you like it. Hit us with the 5 stars.
Do all the good stuff. It's in the holidays. You've got some time to like...
yeah, you guys, you're not listening to this busy.
Yeah, you know, I'm like at work. I don't have time to leave 5 stars, Jake.
Don't act like you can't go on your phone right now.
Yeah, and you just go swipe up to the very top of Spotify and go 5 stars. We're getting up there, you know. Top 1% of potties. You guys like listening. Ooh. We like doing it. You know, it's just best of both worlds. We both get something out of it.
But yeah, so... look, we hope everyone's having good holidays. If you're not on holidays anymore, we hope New Year.
Yeah, we don't know where you're at the moment. We've been recording too much.
We don't know where you're at. But yeah, so let's hop into it, eh?
Let's go.
What do you reckon?
Yeah. All right, Jake, to kick things off, I think the best way to do it would be relatable, not relatable.
These are good.
Before we jump into it, there's been an update on one of my relatable, not relatables. Someone's listening up there.
Someone up there.
One of the big platforms, Spotify, where we get majority of our listeners. Mm. I said on one of the recent relatables, not relatables, that CarView pisses me off.
Oh, bro. CarView's shocking.
It pisses me off because you couldn't change, like pick the artist. You couldn't like a song if you were shuffling a random playlist.
Yeah, it limits you so much to what you can do and for obvious reasons.
Yeah, but because we're one of the top 1% of all potties in the world, Spotify listened.
I wonder if... imagine that. That'd be so funny.
I was driving home. My phone must have automatically updated because it does all that good stuff.
Yeah.
And I was driving home like, oh, I like this song. I'm going to go on and like it.
Yeah.
And I saw it and I was like, ooh, wait, what is this?
It's like, I'm on CarView when I can like it.
CarView has updated. They did everything I said that they couldn't before.
Oh.
You can like a song. You can click on the artist.
Really?
So, and it's all like big. So, you don't have to like squint when you're driving. It's all big. And I'm like, it's off Apple CarPlay, obviously, if your car's got that.
Yeah.
And I was just like, Spotify, about time you listen to Relatables. We're moving up in the world.
See, because it's funny as well because you get in the car and it automatically goes to CarView because it knows. It must know.
Yeah.
It must know you're in a car. But I always forget that it's on CarView. I don't turn it off before I start driving.
Same.
And then... So I'll be mid drive and I'll be like, yeah, I want to like this. And then I'll go and I'll be like, oh, God damn it. But if it's a really good song, I go through the effort of going out of CarView.
Yeah.
And then it just makes it more dangerous. And so silly. Obvious, yeah, they've listened like, I can give it a cheeky like because it's like, it's real big. It's right there. It's like, boom, my eyes aren't even off the road.
Exactly. Now they're good. And one thing to take away from that is these next, we've got 5 relatable, not relatables each. They're obviously super important and going to change the world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're changing the world as we do this.
Yeah, exactly. So do you want to go first or should I?
You go first.
This one I think might be niche, but let me know.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll set the scene. We're out drinking. and like really pissed, you know, I'm coming home, I'm in bed. You know what you do before you go to bed when you're pissed? Right. Watch TikTok.
Okay.
I'm watching TikTok. And some reason, I don't know what I'm watching, but I'm processing it. I wake up in the morning, I go on TikTok again. I've just followed that many random people. Like, because you're on your following, because you got your For You page and you got your following. And normally I like to see what people actually know or up to or whatever.
Okay.
And I kind of like, who the fuck's this? Drunks, Oddie has just gone and followed. I don't know if my fans are just doing whatever or whatever, but I'm waking up. Then I just kept it. When I'm sober, I'd go and click on them and be like, oh, no, unfollow.
See, I don't do that because I haven't had that. My year has been sober.
Yes.
But who knows? I might be starting to do that soon.
Yeah, well, let me know how it falls. But so you would say unrelatable at the moment.
So currently, it's not relatable to me, but I don't know if anyone listening
is. Yeah, let me know, guys. I don't know if that's just a thing I do because I'm just weird.
And I don't know if people maybe like you go and if you're on Instagram, you just start following people too because you're like, oh shit, they're hot.
I'm glad I'm doing it on TikTok because TikTok's like that. So that's kind of, yeah.
Oh, bro. I mean, let's just check a quick relatable, not relatable. Getting drunk and sending messages to people you just shouldn't message.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, that's just an extra one for you guys.
That's like so relatable.
Oh, fucking hell.
You send a shitty DM. Like,
every man does it. A lot of females do it.
They shoot their shot.
We've and then it's like you delete the message in the morning, you know.
Oh, we've had a couple do that too. And I love when you see it and you've seen it's been deleted.
Seen it and chosen not to reply because you think I'll just do it in the morning. It'll be funny. And then it's gone.
Yeah, it's gone. You're like, oh, I swear. Was that me or was that them?
That was... Right, okay, that was just an add-on, but okay, my next one, kind of on, it's still Instagram, but being able to like a message on Instagram has changed the game.
Man, we're just at the pub.
Yeah,
Jake and I have had two beers, so who knows what's gonna happen.
You know,
we're gonna get silly,
a little bit loose.
But yeah, it's good in a way because you're playing the game more because you can just leave a thing on scene.
Yeah.
But it's like kind of nice that I've liked what they've said.
It's like if you feel bad for leaving them on scene, you just hit them with a like because it's like, you know, you've acknowledged it.
But then it's also like, I just got your flirty flirt.
Yeah, true. It's also just a great way to end a conversation.
Yeah, without leaving. Oh, that's so relatable.
That's a good one.
Best. And same with text messages.
I love how they've done it on everything. You can react to a message.
Yeah, it's so good.
I just can't be bothered to think of a reply.
They are geniuses.
Geniuses.
Relatable. Okay, this one is, you're at the Coles checkout, self-checkout, and your item won't weigh itself. Like, you're trying to, like, the thing's just wigging out, and there's no one around to help you. You're just standing there.
And you just stand there as well for ages.
You're turning like, come on, I can't,
because the machine goes into, like, malfunction,
bro. Yeah, you're like, you need the codes to get through, and you're like, I feel silly standing here.
I can't steal this now.
I can't scan my chicken because of what's going on.
I hate that.
Oh, it's so annoying.
Especially if the reason that there's no one around is because they're just chatting shit to one of their coworkers.
Oh, and you like you're hello.
You're fuming.
And I feel silly. I'm just standing there so awkwardly. I'm like, I want to get out of here. Like, what's going on? Oh, it's so annoying.
Wait, that is bad.
I forgot to change machines the other day.
Really?
They couldn't fix it.
Oh, they even came over and tried.
Yeah. Oh.
How good are the new machines at Coles? That for when you have a really big shop,
don't weigh,
and they don't weigh shit.
So good.
Oh my god, the stuff you can get away with just popping in the bag. Well,
they've obviously done the calculation with how much it is to employ someone to self checkout, and like how much
stuff gets stolen,
their stock take or whatever. So, and they've done the calculation and be like, it's worth it.
Yeah.
So they're obviously anticipating me stealing. So.
Dude, I hate confrontation so much that if I worked there and I saw someone steal, I'd let them.
I would too. It's Coles, man.
I'd just be like, oh, didn't see that. Yeah. Sorry, guys.
Relatable?
Relatable. Okay, yes, okay. Relatable. Yep. All right. This is a Snapchat one.
Mm.
So when you get a message on Snapchat, you want to see what it is, but you want time to reply.
Yeah. Ooh.
So I mean, it's a blue chat.
Yeah.
You swipe over. You can read it. Swipe back. Looks like you haven't opened it.
I'm new to the game. I've only recently found out about it.
See, I found out about this last year from Gaffy.
Gaffy told me as well.
And I've been using it.
Really?
Using it. I have been using and abusing it.
Do you look at it and then say like, oh, I don't want to reply. I just don't open it.
If I don't want to reply, I don't give a fuck about leaving people on.
Yeah.
So I'll just leave someone on red.
Mm.
But if I think it's like, you know, initially think it's like a conversation, I want to keep going, then I'll look over and then it gives me time to think about what to say because I don't want them to think I'm leaving them on read when I take a really long time to think of a message to reply.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
Because messaging just sucks. I'd just so much rather talk to them in person.
Oh yeah, I do too. I don't really talk to tune chicks on Snapchat.
No.
So like, I don't really use it that often. Whereas Gaffy's is like slayer.
Oh mate, he's an absolute king.
He's a weapon.
He's a king.
No, but that's definitely right. And it's a good little. I don't know if Snapchat know about that. It's a tip. Yeah. If you guys didn't know about that, tip to like
tips and tricks for Snapchat.
Start tuning on the old Snapchatty, eh?
Yeah.
And it's also a good place to send nudes. Not that we do that. Condone those kind of actions.
Not that we condone that.
Okay, this one's very relatable to our house, but I think it is to like. Majority of people, if you have got a garage or you got a park like a little bit far away, but okay. So I'm in the morning, I'm about to go to work, or I'm about to go to the gym, and I walk all the way to my car, which is up a little hill for us.
Mm.
And I get in the car and I sit there and I've forgotten something.
Oh.
I've just like closed the door, I'm like, oh my god, I've forgotten like something I can't go about, like my earphones or like
your phone, even.
Yeah, your phone,
like, dude, I often forget my keys
or your water bottle, like something you need, and you're just like. Oh, fucking, that's like so far away and daunting. And I'm just angry walking down there. I'm like, just fucking bullshit.
And yeah, you're really angry because you have to go.
Yeah, I have to go and get it. And you're like, because we always say, see you when we're leaving. And I was like, I'm fucking back already, bitch.
Yeah, we are. When we say goodbye and then someone, you come back down. I reckon at least 10 times I'd just come back down, walked in, just not even said a thing to me and walked back.
Yeah, I'm just that angry.
He's just angry and I just go, oh, you forgot something.
Yeah, so annoying.
It is so, and I am so forgetful as well. I do it all the time.
This house sucks for it because our car's like semi-far away.
Yeah, it's really annoying. Even if it wasn't, it would just still be a hassle.
Yeah, exactly.
You'd be annoyed, especially if you're in a rush.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right. When you're taking a shit and it's like hits the water perfectly, but a bit of water splashes back up.
Oh, that's fucking awful. You just feel
disgusting.
That's the worst feeling in the world.
You feel like Poseidon's kissing your butt cheek.
It's so disgusting. It's what
gross,
the fuck?
Gross.
It does the sound to us. It's
just it does the sound and it's annoying when it kind of spreads and hits cheek and butthole, or even if it's perfect and goes straight up butthole only. You're just like, you feel like you've been touched.
You feel disgusting.
You feel just not right about yourself. Even though the
water's clean, but man, oh, it's just like, what is, like, come on, body. Like, it's body, work that shit out. Oh, that is so relatable.
It's so annoying. I hate it.
Oh, that was good. That was a good one.
It's, oh, yeah.
Okay. Come on. Relatable. Mm-hmm. That's one of the best relatables so far.
Yeah.
All right. Buying like a mixed veggie pack from Coles.
Mm.
And you come home, put all the shopping away, and you put in a veggie thing in your fridge. Mm. Just forget about it. And it goes off. The amount of times I'm good with pretty much everything else except for veggies.
Yeah.
I'll use it even once and I just forget about it. And they just, because they go off so quickly, like two or 3 days.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh my God. And I really wanted to eat it and like put in my fucking like burgers. You're and like shit.
Trying to be healthy, buy the good shit.
Yeah.
I've been, the only way I can go around this is I buy frozen veggies.
Yeah.
I don't like doing it. I'd rather the fresh shit, but I have to buy frozen veggies because they stay good forever.
And you know my way around it? What? I asked mum for, she was like, what do you want to give me? I was like, oh, don't give me anything, blah, blah, blah. Actually, could you make me a little veggie patch?
Oh.
So I'm getting spinach, baby spinach, tomatoes for our deck.
Oh,
so I just walk out there, get the scissors, chop that shit up, and it's just going to grow back.
Oh, I love that. I actually love that.
So I'm a thinker, Jake.
And the amount of times you go down, you think, is this spinach still good? You open the bag, smell it, and it's the worst smell ever.
Because it goes off in like 4 days, man.
It's crazy. Oh, my God.
Bad.
I remember going down and there was a cucumber in there.
Yeah.
And I know it was mine as well. It wasn't you.
Yeah.
I know it was mine. I touched it. And my fingers went through it. It was the most disgusting thing. And I had to pick it up and put it in the bin. I was like, oh, gross. Yeah.
But the fridges didn't think about it. Like our...
Because they're hidden.
Yeah, it's hidden. And I bought like a Caesar salad kit the other day.
Yeah.
And I was excited to eat that. I had a bit of chicken to it. And quite a nice little meal.
It's a good meal, though.
I completely forgot about it just because I wasn't looking at it. And I was like, fucking damn it. I wanted to eat that.
And they tried to. It's like they make the drawer clear, but it's just not good enough.
No. I'm just pissed off.
They put it down the bottom.
Fridge makers.
It needs to be in the middle shelf.
Spotify, listen. Fridge makers, listen.
Like, yeah.
Then it needs to beep when it's like a day going off or something. It scans it when you go in.
Okay,
and gives you a little beeper when it's like a day from going off.
Do you want to open the veggie drawer and you think, oh, hey, I do.
Yeah,
maybe, I actually do.
You have one day until it expires.
That's a good one. That one. Oh, it's so annoying. All right, it's another. I do this a lot. I don't know if you do this, but so you get to the shops.
Yeah.
Park your car. You go out and you're walking in the shops and you think, you're like far away already. You're thinking, you're like, oh shit, did I lock my car?
Oh, man.
And you're too far away to click. And actually, my car is the key goes in. So if I'm like, no, I didn't, I have to go all the way back. And when I check and I have locked it, dude, I'm fuming. I am fuming. Yeah.
So this makes me feel good about myself. I'm not a locker, but I'm a handbrake guy.
Oh.
I will always go back. I was like, did I put my handbrake on? Oh my God, especially in my old car because my handbrake was shit.
Yeah, it was not good, eh?
This one's fine, but I'm hoping it goes away. But even in our driveway, I'm like, oh, did I put that on? And I've just freaked out.
I do that too.
And I've got to go back. But locking, I'm sweet. But like that one, I always go back. I'm like, oh, I better go back and double check.
Oh, that's,
I always take a double take. And I'm like, I'm so annoyed with myself. I knew I did it, but I just didn't even fucking calculate it.
I'm so forgetful in general as well. I always do that thing. I know people do this. You know, it's like you walk into the room. It's like, what was I going to get? And then you forget. So you walk out and then you remember again. You're like, oh. Or opening the fridge and it's like, what am I doing in here? Bang. It's like, oh, that's
what I'm exactly. Doing. I have to like, I have a brain fart. I'm like, where am I? Yeah. Why am I here, Oddie?
What is my purpose? Yeah, you have to think. It's like, what was I doing? Yeah. I need to remember let's retrace my steps.
What is my purpose in life?
I'm really bad because I when with the editing, Oddie does one part and I do the other part. The part I do is the clips for all the Instagram and TikTok. And I always forget to post them.
Yeah.
So every now and then I'll get a text from Oddie like, no clip today, ?
And I feel bad sending that.
I know you do too.
Yeah.
But I know you're just doing it to remind
me. Yeah.
And I'm just like, oh shit. And then I have to stop what I'm doing and post it. And I'm like, fuck. And I need to set an alarm or something. Do it same time every day.
Yeah, you're a dog, eh?
But I saw a thing and it was for people to remember stuff. And it was like, okay, when you do something or you know something that you have to do, say tomorrow morning, if your room's clean or whatever and you have stuff in place, put something really in a really odd spot.
Oh, okay.
And then when you wake up the next day, you're like, why is that there? It's like, oh, because I need to do that.
Oh.
And then you put it back, you do the thing, you didn't forget. It's good shit. We need to figure out a way to not forget to take the bins out. It's got to be a really bright thing though.
Yeah, we've always forgotten that because I'm going to like look at my room and be like, oh, yeah, that's all right.
Yeah, we're real bad with our bins on bin night.
Especially yellow bin because this man drinks boxed water
and
just takes up all our yellow bin. Man, gets on my nerve.
I could flatten the boxes.
Oh, you could.
Yeah, you could.
I said it one night. It was like four of them on top of each other. And I was like, fuck me.
Oh, bro. I flattened out. We had some shoe boxes today. We both got some shoes. I flattened them
to make it all fit. That's good. I'm glad. We need to put them out before we leave. Someone remind us, hey.
Yeah, we need to put those bins out before we go away.
Yeah. Okay, whatever you said at the start was relatable.
Yeah.
my last one. When you're out just drinking or socializing anywhere, pubs, clubs, anything, and you wear a nice little bit like festy sunnies, like maybe hair up if it gets dark or whatever, maybe a bit drunk eyes. You want to hunt the drunk eyes. And there's just girls coming up, you're taking them off and putting them on.
Oh.
And at the start, you're like, oh, it's kind of cute. Yeah, whatever. And then you get too drunk and you forget about it and you lose the fucking sunnies.
And then someone's gained some sunnies that night.
Someone's gained some sunnies. And it always happens to me. I lost some on the weekend and I'm spewing. And I was just like, fucking hell. I'm going to get one of those. Is it a lanyard? Is that what it's called?
You can get, I guess you could call it that. Sunny's lanyard, sunny's
and
lace.
Because that ray, it's going to wrap around it. There's no way they can take it off. No one's reaching it over my head.
They go to
take
it off and then it just pops out of their hands back down on you and you're just like.
And there's no way someone's reaching up and getting it over my head without me clocking them.
Yeah.
Clocking this bitch out cold.
Clocking them. Unless, if the girl's attractive, you don't care if they take it.
Oh, no, not at all.
You don't care at all. It's a good reason to go back over and be like, hey, where's my sunnies?
Yeah. If I remember, I just always forget.
It's
so annoying.
So, that's a good one. Relatable.
Relatable.
All right. My last one.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking you lost your phone, but it's just in your hand.
Oh, bro.
You ever looking for it and then like, oh, wait, it's in my hand.
That happens. You go to like type a message or something. I got to reply to that person. Yeah, where's my phone? And you've got it in your hand, like Snapchat's open or whatever.
Heart skipping a beat and you're just like, oh shit, where's my phone? And then it's like, oh, it's in my hand.
How does your body do that? Eh? It's so weird, bad. Eh? That is so bad.
The human mind is just so, it's odd.
It is an odd fucking thing.
I've tried things in the past for my memory. Like, have you ever heard of the company Lifecycle? And it's a company from Byron and it's the mushroom extracts.
I have, yeah.
I've tried them before. They're expensive. And I've tried them before. And I don't know if it's like a placebo, but I just don't think it works.
Mm.
I think like bad memory once, always got a bad memory.
Yeah, it's shocking. It's like, I feel like game, like sort of like, you know, those, what are those games you used to play as a kid? Like you got to remember the cards, flip them over and memory. I think it's just called memory.
Yeah, it's just
like
called memory, yeah.
Shit like that. And all that. I feel like that would help.
I'm not good at that either.
Really? I used to be good as a kid, but I haven't played it since I was
like, you know what could help is you can download games on your phone that are like cognitive games.
I'm sure that would help with your brain.
Puzzle
like
games.
Working. Mm. It's articulating different things of memory.
Our IQs make articulating on it. Oh my God. You must have downloaded one of those games. It's a fucking big word for you.
Yeah, Subway Surfers has got me going.
But what did you use it in? Articulating what?
I can't remember, mate. It worked. That's all you got to know.
Rightio.
That was relatable, that not was, relatable. That one was relatable.
That was... Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Those are good. Those are good. Right, yeah. That was relatable, not relatable.
Okay, Jake. We mentioned at the start, this is our third potty today.
Yeah.
And we've been talking too much.
We've been talking way too much. Okay.
So I'm going to change things up a little bit. I hope this is allowed.
Okay.
On the old Spotify and social media.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is the... It's a TikTok.
Mm-hmm.
And it's quite a good one. It is songs that are 100% perfect. Okay. And I think maybe we'll listen to one or pause it and we can react.
Okay.
But we're just going to vibe. The listeners are going to vibe. They're going to be in the car. But this song is perfect.
Okay, cool. So they're getting a cheeky listen and then they're getting our reviews. Genuine reviews.
I can tell you the songs as well.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, do that.
Because it doesn't say that.
Because they might like them and want to write it down.
Yeah, exactly.
Your opinion, 100% perfect.
Nobody wants to rule the world. I'm just going to play more. I can't tell you. Little Dark Age, MGMT. Ooh, September, truly a masterpiece. Oh, I forgot about this. Bohemian Rap City.
Bohemian Rap
City. Oh, the chain, Fleetwood Mac. This is a tune. Again. Jolene. Dolly Parton. Yeah, forgot about these.
Shit, these are all old.
I don't know.
I don't even know this.
The Reaper.
Which song is it?
That's it.
All right, that's all of them. All right.
I thought that'd be a little quick little thing. But it's going to get you. We're going to falls. It would have already happened when this is coming out.
Yeah.
We get in the mood. The way music makes you feel, man. Lil Nas just gets in my feels, you know?
Dude, I'm so keen for Lil Nas. But I want to quickly say, out of those songs, personally, the one I like the most is The Chain by Fleetwood Mac.
Mm.
I've always loved it. And then Bohemian Rhapsody is just, I think that's like worldwide. Everyone loves that.
I'm in controversial opinion. My mom loves Dolly Parton and always Jolene. Really? It's like when I was a kid, she like just put on like a CD. She had a CD of Dolly Parton, I'm pretty sure.
Yep.
And that's Jolene. Fucking, memories coming back to me, Jake.
I used to fucking, do you ever have like a song there's a song ever come on, you think, man, I remember that from when I was a kid.
Yeah, exactly.
I remember that from when I was a kid. Shit. But no, I remember The Chain. Okay, I was working with a carpenter and he didn't have like a Spotify in that yet.
Mm.
And he had this iPod that he would connect to a speaker that had, he somehow got Triple M's like USB database of like, it's like got like, had like 50,000 songs on it, he said. And then he was just playing and every single song that came on, they're all bangers, but he would tell me the artist when it came out, just some facts about
cool
it.
Facts.
It
That's cool.
It was so cool. Like, he just loved it. And then I remember The Chain came on and I was like, what is this one? It was, I don't know what it was. I was just vibing with it.
Yeah.
It just was like connecting with me. And ever since then, I have absolutely loved it. And then it's in one of my favorite movies.
Yeah.
And now I just fucking love it.
That's a good story behind it too.
Yeah. That's why I love it.
It's so cool that like, when he was brought up, it would have been go down to the local, whatever music store you call it, or whatever CD shop or vinyl shop. I don't know what they're actually called.
Yeah.
And he would go buy it, like look at it, look at the songs on the back, like get keen to listen to it.
Yeah.
Like it was a full like effort of the day to go do it.
Bro.
And you come home, put on even a CD player on the, what's the thing?
I don't know. A record player.
Man, that's bad. Fuck. And like you just jam out and you're like, this is sick. And then you're like, detail, like detailing, looking at all the details in it and stuff, all the artists when it came out.
And the thing about back then is you would have got it, you would have put it on, then you would have just sat down and listened
to it. Oh, yeah.
We don't really do that anymore.
No, we take advantage of like just having everything so accessible on our phone.
Yeah, we lack appreciation for it. Like we can go and get every single one of those classics remastered.
Yeah, remastered.
And it's just so, so lucky. But this guy... I was talking, so I worked with him for a fair while. He's such a nice guy, really fucking good builder.
Yeah.
And, but he's old enough to, his first house that he bought was $5,000.
But he must be like 100.
$5,000. It was in the country.
Yeah.
But his first house that he bought was five.
Man. That's why like your grandparents say, why don't you have a house yet, Jake?
Oh,
like,
bro.
We had one crazy. When we were your age.
Yeah, and no, it's crazy, hey.
That's mental.
He fucking...
No, I actually genuinely wish I was born in like the 1940s.
Yeah, you know... Oh,
no, when was after the war?
45.
Yeah, so like, yeah. I'm really like 1950. Like it's so all
you
over.
Wouldn't really want to be... Yeah, you would want to be after, like a few years after that. But I saw this really funny thing of a guy going, yeah, like if you could go back in time and I got sent, I don't think I'd change much in the way that it's like, if you think about it, so someone pulls out this old, old phone and you go, oh, you know, in the future, like they just fit in your pocket and they're on a screen and you can literally look up anything and it has the answer and they're like, what, how do they do it? And you go, I don't know. And they're like, well, you're talking shit then.
Yeah,
you're
not
from the future.
I don't know.
They're like, it's like, no, I am from the future. It's like, okay, well, all right, it's 1950 in the next election, who wins? Tell me right now, do you know who the Prime Minister of Australia was in 1950?
No.
And you're gonna be like, I don't know, shit, Barack Obama. And you're gonna be like, what?
Yeah.
The only thing you could do is tell them stuff that's going to happen 40 years in advance and then wait 40 years and then they'll believe you.
Yeah, legit, eh?
I wouldn't be able to
tell them. I couldn't tell you anything.
I couldn't. There's no way I could convince them that I'm from the future.
Only thing I could like predict is like maybe when my parents would be born or something.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe. That's just a maybe too.
Yeah.
Like, well, not even a maybe. It's like a guarantee, but like still, then it's this, they could be like still coincidence. That's something and they're not going to believe you. The only thing like... I don't even know any sports games I could bet on. I don't know anything. Or the only thing that I could do that would benefit me. So like the future, me going into the past would not change our future because of this reason. But all I can think of is getting a job, saving and buying a property around here somewhere and just holding on to it.
No.
Just holding
on. One better.
What?
Bitcoin.
As
soon as it came out.
As soon as Bitcoin's on, just... buying some Bitcoin and then waiting a couple of years.
And then you're a billionaire.
True. Or actually, as soon as like Apple stock comes out, Facebook stock, or the Google
all
stock.
All the good shit.
All these stocks
come out. We would know about that, yeah.
You just start buying and then you're just rich. It's like, I don't know. I'm not from the future. I'm just rich. Man. Yeah. I'm just a good stock investor.
That's what I do, bro.
That's what I do.
Businessman. That's me.
So yeah, it's just so funny that seriously thinking about it, like even if you went back to the time before electricity and it's like, you know, electricity thing. It's like, yeah, but how's it made? I don't know. You don't know how it's made.
No.
How funny.
It's so weird.
It just shows how, I don't know, it makes me feel dumb.
Maybe we're just dumb.
Makes me feel dumb.
Yeah, it does. Fuck, maybe we should do like learn some more stuff about it, culture.
Yeah, maybe. But yeah, what were we talking about? Relatable, not relatable then?
No, that was the music, man.
Oh, that was the music.
We're going too many, eh? Fucking hell.
Too many podcasts, guys. Yeah. Shit. Oh, well. Okay, short episode this time, guys. Sorry about that. But we aren't going to change up the way we do things. We're still going to get Oddie to hit us with a
fact. I don't know if this is a fact, but it's something like you should do. Like, just like have a crack because it's fun.
Yeah.
Just start practicing how to DM chicks.
Oh!
Or vice versa. Chicks DMing dudes.
Yeah.
Because it's a game, Jake.
Dude, it is a game. Oddie's gone through it.
Oh, it's a game, man. And it's fucking funny.
I enjoy
like freaking out and just like, what do I do? I don't know what to fucking do, man.
And the pep talks from the boys.
And you're like, and then you still don't know if you're right or wrong. Oh,
shit.
Yeah, but that's all I've got, man. This is the third one for today. That's all I've got.
Yeah, we're rough.
It's not the best. We're rough. We're coming off fucking three potties. It's like a bender, man.
Three potties and we had to go. We went to the gym, had dinner and stuff, had a few beers and we were like, we got to pump one out for the people.
Yeah.
They deserve it. Mm. They deserve it. So thank you for listening.
Thank you very much. Sorry it's a little bit shorter, but...
We'll be back and we'll be ready, rearing and ready to go for the next episode.
We're having a break, aren't we?
One more episode. Yeah, one more episode after this.
Okay, I'll cut that out.
One more.
Okay. Thank you very much, everybody, for listening.
Have a good day.
See you later.